So that is how I trace it forward, yeah, to Africa.
Okay, but yes, I do agree with you on those all that you have spoke. But I do assume that you were born in 1960s. I do assume that.
I was born in 1950s.
50s.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, in that period, of course, racism was very, I mean, the degree of it was very high. It is still high systematically, okay. But there was other, I mean, movements going there, Pan-African movements generally, but they were socialists, communists, and all other kinds of movements by the time. So when you grow up, why didn't you subscribe to all other kinds of movement, and you thought that Rastafari was the proper tool for you to solve those problems that you felt that you were facing as a black person? See, in England. Why Rasta?
All right.
Yeah.
That's what I'm explaining.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So firstly, England was not I home.
Yeah.
And that is how we felt,
okay,
and experienced. Yeah. Being in school, car names in the street,
yeah,
fighting when they call your name,
oh,
monkey,
yeah, oh,
go back to your own country, wag nigga cool, right? Those kind of words, right? And then so obviously you realize that, well, why am I getting this treatment? It's because I'm not part,
yeah,
of this country.
This country.
Yeah. So where do I really belong? Yeah, because we go to Jamaica, they call we English.
But when you go to Jamaica, they call you English.
English.
Because only because you lived in England.
Yes, we born and go in England,
oh,
so you're,
yeah,
English.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Yeah? Right? So it's where we belong, so we say Africa.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Africa is where us came from originally. Yeah,
and nobody can contest.
All right, so
yeah,
that is where I come from originally.
Yeah.
So that's where I look to.
Mm-hmm.
With Rastafari philosophy now,
mm-hmm,
you have that. All of it is there. Yeah, because
mm-hmm,
them say, yes, Selassie is the true and living God sitting on the throne in Ethiopia. So no, God is not mystic. He's not up in the sky.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But a living man.
But a living man.
Somewhere
sitting
in
throne.
Ethiopia.
All right,
in Ethiopia.
In Ethiopia
is in Africa.
All right.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So now this is in the Bible. It says, "Our God shall come and shall not keep silent."
Uh-huh.
In Psalms 50.
Yes,
you over.
Yes.
So the elders gave the Rastafari elders said, by using the Bible,
uh-huh,
we come to the conclusion. Say,
uh-huh,
the description is of a man, and that man is the Selassie the first.
Will you call that blackening the Bible? Will you
call
that
it?
I mean, that process, like that a rebellious kind of thing by the Rastas. Will you call that the blackening of the Bible?
Well, the Bible is for I and I is a Bible.
Yes.
Yeah. I and I, them call it the Book of Life, but that is a book. That book don't have life.
Okay.
Yeah.
I and I got life.
I and I have the life. So I and I are the book.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Yes,
so
sir.
If you put a Bible here.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, on his table now. He can't do nothing.
He can't do nothing, yes.
Yeah?
Uh-huh.
They're Jehovah's.
Yes.
He can't do a thing, it's a book.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Get them say that, will your name be written there in the Lamb's Book of Life? That's what them saying. So what is this Book of Life? I and I are living the life. So I and I are the book. Yeah? Because you still have to say, I come and say, right, that his glory is in the Bible.
In the Bible, yeah.
In the Bible. And he said that you must read the Bible to find truth for yourself. Yeah? So he read it and find it in his glory in the Bible. So I want glory is in other Bible there.
So to many, uh-huh, still, even here in Tanzania, and I do assume some many parts of the world,
uh-huh,
Rastafari is still a contradictive idea, a complex idea.
Yeah,
but on a simple terms,
yeah,
on a simple terms,
yeah,
what can you explain Rastafari even to a little child who is up there, has been bombarded and indoctrinated negative things about Rastafari?
Yeah.
What can you explain to him or her or to anyone in a simple terms?
Yeah.
What is Rastafari?
Yes.
Yeah.
Rastafari is peace, love, and unity. Rastafari is the knowledge of oneself. Mm-hmm. Yeah? That is what Rastafari is. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Rastafari is naturality, simplicity. It's simple. Mm-hmm. From a one have the right mindset and know themselves. From a one know themselves. Mm-hmm. Yeah? They know God, they know the Almighty, they know everything, they know the universe. Mm-hmm. From you know yourself. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So that is it basically.
The Rastafari.
Yes, I. God is man and man is God. That Rastafari come to say.